Oh, thank you so much. Oh, please be seated. Thanks so much. It's great to be here. It's great to be here at our annual Teacher of the Year celebration. We appreciate all the hard work and all the great results that so many of you produced in our state. We are an example of, you know, we're ranked number one in education by U.S. News and World Report 2 years in a row. Number one, of course, in higher education for 8 years in a row. And it's something that we've put a lot of emphasis on, particularly understanding the importance of attracting and retaining good teachers. And since I've been governor in 2019, we've done $4.6 billion to increase teacher pay. And I can tell you that's never been done in the history of the state of Florida before. And this year alone, we have a categorical provision in our budget of $1.25 billion that can only be used to increase teacher salaries. And we're going to do even more in the coming session. So we have 74 District Teachers of the Year. They're nominated by their colleagues in their individual districts. Five finalists of the 74 have been chosen, and the 2024-2025 Teacher of the Year will be announced at the gala on Thursday night. And today I have the honor of awarding checks to the five finalists. Now, one of the things I asked was, for the finalists, we wanted to increase the awards, and so it used to be $15,000, now it's $20,000, and then the Teacher of the Year is going to get a total of $50,000, which I think is really, really positive recognition. All 74 District Teachers of the Year will receive $10,000 later this week, so congratulations. So we have checks here. I'm not sure that the bank will accept these, but you know, I think we're good for it. So I'm going to call people up. You come up and get your check. We'll snap a pic and thank you for what you've done. So we'll start with Samantha Nielsen from Florida State Samantha Nelson, Florida State University School. Jennifer Brown, Marion County. Heather Stewart, Walton County. Jamie Suarez or Jaime Suarez, Hernando County. Is it Jamie? Okay. And Dr. Clayton Nyland from Hillsborough County. Thanks so much. I really appreciate the hard work. You know, we've worked hard to be able to help teach, and the pay is one thing, and we're fortunate the state's doing very well, and we have a really good budget, we have low debt, all this other stuff, so it allows us to do that, as well as reduce taxes. Things like the back-to-school tax holiday is coming up, and so we're proud of that, but we've also tried to help with different types of policies. I mean, for example, the cell phones in the classroom. You know, we felt that that's something that's not productive, and it's hard to teach when nobody's paying attention because they're worried about texting. And when we talked about this a couple years ago, you know, I mean, there's kind of anything we do, people are going to say this, whatever. That's just the way politics goes. But now states across the country are recognizing, you know what? It's better for the students and doing that, but it's also much better for teachers. And then we also, with our teachers' Bill of Rights, recognize that the classroom should be orderly, and you have a right to that. Other students have a right to do it. But the teachers have a right to do that as well. So we've been receptive as teachers have told us different things that can be improved. I know there's other things that we're going to do in the ensuing years, and we look forward to working with you all to make Florida an even better place for education. So thanks, great job, and God bless everybody.